Okay, so you're trying to get into a top college, but your resume is kind of a little bit lacking. But then you also missed a lot of the deadlines for summer internships. And just FYI, some places are still accepting applications, so don't write those off completely, but they're also pretty competitive. You should try to have a backup plan. And one of the best ways to prove to colleges that you are both intellectually curious and that you're capable of college-level work is to seek out research opportunities. So an alternative to those programs is to try to just cold email professors. In some cases, I think this is actually better than certain programs, even though, yes, colleges can identify those really prestigious programs. But if you find a professor who is already interested in the research that you're kind of like itching to do, it might actually further your application even more. Because then when you go to craft your essays and you're thinking about your application narrative, that is going to be a lot easier to discuss. You can say, I've already done research in this. I loved it. I know I'm going to like it. Now, reaching out to these professors does take a bit of initiative, but here are some basic first steps. So first, decide if the research that you want to do can be done remotely. This will have a lot to do with your intended field of study. For example, computer science, that kind of research can really be done for the most part entirely remotely. Let's say you're into maybe mechanical engineering though, that if you're trying to get lab experience, that's going to be harder. Same thing goes for, you know, biology. If you're thinking about going pre-med, you're going to want to try to be in the lab if you can. So once you know that, here's what you do if the research cannot be done remotely. You want to only seek out professors. It's a lot harder for rural students if you don't have a college. If that's you, another option could be to try to think about colleges who are near your relatives. So if you have family who maybe are out living in a city, try to contact them and ask, you know, if you could spend the summer living there. If there's a college that's like an hour away from you and you don't think you can make that commute every single day, you could also try asking the professor if they wouldn't mind a hybrid schedule. A lot of in-person programs are also hybrid anyway, and at least that would reduce the number of days that you'd actually have to commute. Now, if the work that you want to do can be done remotely, you've got some flexibility to work with professors from all over. You can start by finding people who are working at, you know, your dream school. But something that I think actually works way better that I would recommend is trying to seek publications through Google Scholar. That might be how you're going to find, you know, somebody who has recently published something on work that you're really interested in. So to do that, just go to scholar.google.com and then type in a few keywords that have to do with what you're actually interested in. Be very specific. You should know exactly what it is that you want to research. And I don't say that to intimidate you or make you think that you're not able to do this kind of work. I think that you are, but I want you to really figure out why it is that you're interested in whatever it is that you're trying to study. I'll put it to you this way. I studied creative writing. I should not know more about, like, computer science current events than you. And if you do know that you just like a field, but you haven't really found your niche in it, I really recommend, you know, trying to deepen that interest. I'll talk about how to do that in another video. Okay, so you typed in those keywords into Google Scholar. When you're on the results page, go to the left and sort by date. You want to actually find current research so that you know the professor or the researcher is actually still interested in that topic. If it's something that they worked on 10 years ago, chances are they might not be interested in that anymore. They might have moved on to something else. But either way, for both in-person and remote options, once you found an article, something that was published, read it. Yeah, all of it. Oh, it's 75 pages. Yeah, read it. This is the field that you are going to spend your life in. If you can't read, you know, an entire research paper on it, you might not actually be that interested in it. Now, if it is, you know, really jargon heavy, that doesn't mean that you're like not smart enough to understand it. But I want you to be, again, academically curious enough to look up search terms that you don't fully understand. Or instead of using ChatGPT to write essays, feed it through that, like just a couple of paragraphs that you're kind of lost on, and then ask ChatGPT to either summarize it or clarify it or simplify it. I'm just kidding. I know none of you use ChatGPT to write your essays. So once you know the professor that you want to work with, look them up, find their faculty page, or maybe, you know, identify the institute or think tank that they work at. And once you've gotten their email address, it should be easier to find than you think. You can go ahead and send them an email. And here is how I would format it. First, as a general rule, you want to start with a compliment. Make them like you. A compliment gets that email read. You can tell them, you know, you found their article, you thought it was really, really fascinating. Make it believable, make sure that they realize why you like it. Don't just say, I found this article, it was really cool. Make it clear that you actually read it. Explain why you thought it was interesting or like a significant breakthrough. And then explain the connection that you have to it. So this is when you're moving into the why you specifically find that interesting. So maybe it's what you want to do your senior research project on. Maybe, you know, it's specific cancer research and you're hoping to be an oncologist in the future. Or maybe it disproves, you know, a widely held belief in that specific field, or has the potential to disprove something like that. The next section, you're going to tell them a little bit about yourself, including that you're a high school student. You can tell them, you know, what high school you attend. And then you want to list any relevant clubs that you're a member of, initiatives you've started. I even had a student who put at the end of his email, in this section anyway, after, of course, listing off other things that he had done, that he was like an avid consumer of like three specific podcasts that he thought would make sense for the professor. And he was right. The professor actually knew exactly which one of those podcasts was. So it worked. To be clear, this was like a computer science podcast. You didn't tell him like, I love Joe Rogan. Like, don't do that. And then after you've told them a little bit about yourself, you want to shift into asking them to mentor you. Explain, you know, the skills that you'd be excited to contribute, and don't say that you don't have any skills. Really look into what their research requires and think what you could actually do in the lab. You can also just say, like, I'm interested in better understanding the research process for this field. I'd love to help out in any way that I can. It could mean that you're doing a lot of, like, the grunt work, or work that you weren't exactly looking to do. As an example, I had a student who reached out to a professor who did say yes, but he asked, like, do you know Python? Now, she was going to go pre-med, but she knew a little bit of Python, and she was honest about, like, her proficiency level. And he basically said, like, you know what, I think you'd be great. You can pretty much learn Python as you're doing this. We're not asking for anything, like, super crazy. And he mentored her that summer. And she still loved it, even though she has no interest in computer science. Just being able to shadow other parts of the lab or be part of the team that, you know, contributed to that was exciting for her. And it should be exciting for you too. This should be something that you're itching to do. Now, after you sent the email, you should send several more because you're going to get a lot of people turning you down, and that's okay. In some cases, they might just like ignore your email completely. If they do reply, but they tell you that, you know, they're not available to mentor students, they've taken on too many students already, or maybe they're just like not currently doing research that summer, you can respond and thank them for their time. You might also add something like, you know, if you have any colleagues who are interested in similar research to yours, and you know that they're looking for students to help them out this summer, please feel free to pass along my resume to them. I hope you have a wonderful summer. Again, kindness is maturity. These are people, right? If you feel like it would be helpful to have an example of how this would work, go ahead and leave a comment. Let me know what major you're interested in, and if you already know what you want to research in the field, go ahead and drop that in the comments as well. If you have any universities nearby, let me know what they are. If you don't, that's okay as well. Just let me know what your situation would be, and I'm happy to make a video just walking you through the process, just so that other students get an example of this. And if you're planning on actually doing this, good luck.